I had had a labrum and ligament repair in my hip. I was limping everywhere I went. It was actually horrible.
So Ms. Johns came to me initially after having another procedure on her hip, a different type of procedure called arthroscopy. Unfortunately for her, that did not help her. And she very early after that progressed to having pretty severe arthritis inside the hip that extremely interfered with her ability just to do daily stuff.
I came across Dr. Curry and I was reading his background and saw that he was a younger guy, and I knew being as young as I was that I would have to have a revision if I lived to be a nice good old age, and I didn't want different doctors to be doing my surgery.
She decided to have the hip replacement mostly because the things that we were trying that were non-operative weren't providing her the relief that she needed to be as active as she wanted to be. And because she's so athletic, we chose to perform the anterior approach for her. It's a little bit faster recovery. It warrants a little bit more active lifestyle than some of the other approaches.
With myself into weightlifting, I did not want to risk not being able to do certain things that I did before. After about 6 months after surgery, I was beginning to feel really good. I was released to do normal exercise. I slowly started training harder, found a coach to help with my diet plan and my workouts. Here in 8 weeks, I'll be competing.
She had this dream of becoming a fitness person and potentially even competing. And where she was when she first saw me, she would have never been able to do something like that.
I always tell everyone, if they need any kind of replacement, go to SJRI, and if they need a new hip, I know a good doctor.
To have them come back when they're fully healed and they're realizing their dreams to say, thank you. Thank you for making my life better. That's exactly why we do what we do.